Dear community, as a matter of fact, the last video of this kind by me dates back to the last decade. After a long time, I'm now once more presenting you a sale video in which I'm selling you my reviewed and tested hardware at somewhat reduced prices. Due to the high shipping costs I need to bear, that doesn't always exactly work out the way I'd like. Either way, what I want is that the hardware goes into the hands of my community. I want to live knowing the hardware is in good, passionate hands. Today I unfortunately don't have any amazing CPUs or graphics cards for sale, but more so a box into which we usually build that precious stuff into. We're talking of PC cases. Now before I go ahead and list all models I have up for sale, a short explanation on why I'm selling these. You gotta know, over the last few years, I've been sent quite the number of PC cases to review and I simply can't keep all of them. From time to time I've sold one or two. Still, the majority of it is still sitting in my rather small storage room, which now happens to be completely full. So I don't know where else I could store all these cases. And since I have some pretty expensive Intel Alder Lake CPU test preparations to go through, and since I've had to deal with a couple medical issues this year with bills and medication to pay for, I could maybe kill two birds with one stone. I regain a lot of storage room, so there's space for new stuff, and I earn a couple of euros, even though it's probably not a lot, due to those immense shipping costs I mentioned before. Alright, enough beating around the bush. The following models are up for sale. All has been used, but is in exceptionally good mint condition. I've only really used those for my reviews, and that's about it. I'll now sort the cases by brand. First off, the Antec Darkcube, a very special and sleek case, which however only supports Micro ATX and Mini ATX motherboards. At a price of 189 euros, there's at least some profit left for me. I'd be very happy about it. Then I also happen to own the Antec DF700 Flux at 69 euros, and the close relative to it, namely the DF600 Flux at 67 euros. Moving on to the Be Quiet PureBase 500DX in white. I'd like to get 69 euros for that one. I'll content myself with less for the PureBase 500, also in white. 55 euros is what I'd like to see for it. It gets a whole lot more expensive with Be Quiet's giant and premium solution going by the name of DarkBase 700 for 119 euros. That for sure is a high-end case. Next, the Deepcool CL500 at a mind-blowing 54 euros. Good airflow and a USB Type-C port. I also happen to have a Sharkoon TG6 RGB standing around. I'd like 69 euros for it. For those premium case buyers among you, I do actually have something rather sleek and minimalistic by the brand Fractal Design, namely a Vector RS for 99 euros and the Define S2 Vision RGB for 179 euros, which certainly is quite a bit of DNG money. In fact, I even have two more Fractal cases, the airflow-oriented Meshify S2 at 119 euros and the Define R6 with a solid steel side panel, so no tempered glass panel, at 109 euros. Next up, I have something a bit more exotic for you guys, heading in the direction cube. Thick, strong glass not only at the front, but on both sides as well. This is the AI Crystal Cube AR3 with 5 already pre-installed ARGB fans featuring proprietary connections, including the needed ARGB controller and remote control for it. The price? 79 euros. A very closely related model, the AI Crystal Cube AR, also with 5 fans, but only simple RGB lighting, 75 euros. Furthermore, I still have the Bitphoenix Enso Mesh in white here for 54 euros, the Kolink Phalanx for 57 euros, the slightly exotic Sahara P35, including 4 original fans at 54 euros, and last but not least, a case by the brand FSP, the case going by the name of CMT340 at a price of 59 euros. So as you can see, that's quite a hill of cases I have up for sale, eating up a lot of space. As said before, I'd love to knock down those prices even further, but with those cheaper ones, I fear I may run into the risk of not only making zero profit, but actually losing money for all the work and effort I put into this. Nonetheless, I hope those more expensive cases will help balance things out for me. That's the theory, at least. The condition of all these cases is pretty much as good as new. Those of you that have already bought stuff off of me know that. I really take good care of my hardware and value it. All shipping costs I will take care of. All you are paying is the prices I listed, and that's all. The remaining costs I will deal with. Although I will have to make it very clear, I can and will only ship to countries within the EU, European Union, since I neither want any customs issues to deal with on my end, nor on your end, and vice versa. If you happen to be interested in one or the other case, I'd be very happy to hear about it via email, the very old-fashioned way of communication. The following is my email address you see on the screen. Needless to say, I don't know yet whether or not I will be able to sell any of it and how much money will be left for me at the end of the day after shipping. Admittedly, these aren't the best deals out there. Just in case I do happen to make some profit, I'll certainly invest the money into those upcoming Intel Alder Lake CPU reviews. It's not only the CPUs that apparently should end up being quite pricey, but DDR5 memory won't be cheap either. As for the motherboard, I'm not sure yet. We'll see what will happen. I'm hoping for the best. Thank you so much, everyone, for your support. Watching, liking, and commenting on my videos already means and helps a lot. Please take care, everyone.